Hello, welcome to week one of Homer. This is the class that I'm teaching for you. And the topic for this video is nouns. Nouns. Gotta love nouns. So the first thing that we need to know, of course, is what is a noun, right? Now, definitions are very important. Definitions. So, a noun is a person, place, thing, or idea. You need to know that. If you did not already know that, you need to know that. You also need to know that there are two families of nouns, so to speak. These are common nouns and proper nouns. A common noun is, and I quote the dictionary here, a noun such as chair or fear that names a class of persons or things or any individual of a class of persons or things. In other words, it's not actually the name of a particular, of a specific person, place, thing, or idea. That's a proper noun. And proper nouns are always capitalized, always capitalized. So if you do not capitalize a proper noun in your written assignments for me, you can almost certainly expect your grade to be at least slightly penalized as a result. Sorry, I didn't make up the rules for grammar. I just enforced them. I crack me up. Anyways, enough of that, I suppose. Nouns also have number. This is a fairly easy concept, I believe. Nouns are either singular or plural. A singular noun means there's just one, and plural means there's more than one. There are two or more, depending on, you know, how you look at it. In addition to this, because of the particular way I teach grammar, you also need to know that nouns have jobs. You probably didn't know that, but nouns have jobs. They're not particularly high-paying jobs, but they're there nonetheless. And the nouns of, oh, nope, that's the exact same thing I just posted. I'm going to delete that because that doesn't make any sense. And instead, I'm going to try to do this correctly this time. Let's see. Cross your fingers, please. There we go. Nouns have jobs and sentences. This is what I was just talking about before I made a mistake. For now, there are two noun jobs you need to pay attention to. And a noun can be the subject of a sentence. And when it becomes necessary, you will abbreviate this SN for subject noun. Very clever. Or a noun can be the object of a preposition. And you will please abbreviate, abbreviate object of a preposition as OP. This idea of labeling and abbreviating specific nouns as either SN or as OP is something that you will be doing in your first official grammar assignment for me for this week. I guess that's really it for this particular video. I can't think of anything else that I need to tell you about nouns at the moment. So have fun and see you in the next video.